Welcome to the Vector Garden. Let's take a look at InDesign and text wrapping. So in this case, we have a list. And you see it's very, very bad justification. We don't see any hyphenation where there should be some because there's enough space for it. So what does affect this whole thing? First of all, what you should do in order to figure this out is go to type and then show the hidden characters. So we see if there are some hidden characters that are interfering. And you see this is actually the case here because we have this line break. So this is a hard line break and of course this will affect this. So let's just get that out of here, but it doesn't change anything. So let's get to the next one. So this is German. And of course, when we have German text, then we should have the German language applied. Let's check that out. Type and tables, character, and check out the language. And you see this is Lithuanian and that's of course wrong. So let's set that to German. There we have German, but still nothing is improving here. The next thing, of course, it's the width of the paragraphs, which is affecting all of this. And of course, this list has not been generated using InDesign's list function. So of course, you should do that. And then also, when you have this kind of short list items, then aligning them left will usually give you better results, but maybe it has to be like that. We want to have that fully justified. Let's get to the next ones. The next one is, of course, the hyphenation settings. So let's again go into type and tables and to the paragraph, and then we get into the hyphenation settings. And in here, hyphenation is turned on. That's important. That makes it possible that something gets hyphenated. So below 20 letters, no word gets hyphenated. That's too much. So let's set that to 5. And of course, you might want to have only 2, and there are 2 as well, so that 2 letters can stand on their own. And then that is happening a lot in my own writing. So you have a limit of 2 hyphens, which is sometimes not sufficient. So it should be 3, and sometimes in my text I even need 4 of them. So you might want to adjust that even more, like this. But again, it doesn't change anything. So these huge gaps are affected by justification. So let's take a look at justification. And then we have this here, and you see desired is even narrower than what's in the font. So that's okay if you want it like that, and maybe more maximum. But then, of course, the rule of this is to allow more. You might want to allow some letter spacing, and here as well. And then you might even want to allow glyph scaling. So for longer text, you can give it like this. This is kind of the value that only really font specialists will even notice. When you're doing packaging, then of course 97% is just a joke. So in packaging, you usually see 40% or the like. So let's turn that on. But so let's take a look at this. Of course, this needs to be positive like this. And you see, we get some better results, slightly better, but still it's not really good. Why don't we get hyphenation in this? And that is a setting that we find again in the character settings. So let's go in here again. In there, you can select a word or several words, and then you can set them to no break. And you see this has actually happened here. So you can turn that off like this, and then again, and we go in here, and again it's set up strangely. What gives? the only thing that can now do this no break is automatic functionality. So in this case, either a script which will not run just on its own, or grep. Let's go into the paragraph styles. Here we have actually a paragraph style applied, and let's go into it like this. And there we have grep styles. And actually, we have a style in this that forces no break onto the complete paragraph. So let's delete that. And then you see, finally, we get hyphenation. Let's get into this again. There's one thing that you can do to force hyphenation. You can insert a soft hyphen. So you press on the Mac, Command Shift and the hyphen like this, and then you have that soft hyphen. On Windows, it's of course Control Shift and the hyphen. That's another thing to enforce hyphenation where you want it. And if you want to suppress it, you can use the same shortcut, put your mark in front of the word and then press that, and then you have enforced no hyphenation on that specific word. So this is how to debug hyphenation and justification in InDesign.